Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern is set to take a lead role in a global campaign to stop the spread online of extremism and terrorism when she heads to Paris next month. Her role in this campaign is likely to put the blowtorch on social media, and here to discuss the implications in our TALANOA is AUT journalism lecturer Richard Pamatatau. Kia ora, Richard, welcome to the show.
Morning.
So first of all, given the recent events that have happened in New Zealand, this is a discussion, something that needs to happen. But what about freedom of speech?
Well, that's the really interesting thing. So, big picture, this is a very powerful move by the Prime Minister, who's using her undeniable political capital to make moves in the global scene. But what we also need to think about is what's at risk here. So there needs to be a bit of, yes, we absolutely need to put some controls and some boundaries around what is able to be shared. But the big thing is the how, and what is it going to look like? Because I wouldn't want to see people's ability to share things that some might find upsetting closed down by this. So she's walking a tightrope, and we need to see what the outcome is going to be. Yeah. It might not be an outcome, actually.
Absolutely, there needs to be some sort of balance. I mean, but surely if this is going to go ahead, you know, and with stuff that we've seen online with hate speech, you know, especially recently, it has to be the right thing, right? The right move, the right direction that we're taking?
Well, it's not so much about whether or not it's a right move, it's about how is this going to happen. So it's the how we need to see. There's no doubt that something needs to happen, but how is it going to be measured? Will there be boundaries? Will somebody have to sign up? And what will these social media giants do? Because some of them have populations or members bigger than countries. Are they going to be told what to do by somebody from the global south? No. So it is important that she's hooking up with the French president. That gives it more clout. But it is about what is it going to look like.
Yeah, exactly, because social media is a free-for-all at the moment. It's something that's largely unfiltered. What do you think the key thing that we should be focusing on in terms of getting rid of hate speech online, getting rid of all that extremism talk on social media platforms?
Well, we know what hate speech is. There are legal definitions for that. The broader issue is how do we educate the population, people, to know and recognise these things? We've seen that with the rise around Israel Folau and his comments. Is it hate speech or is it his belief? There are arguments there. And it's going to be important for the Pacific population because our people are using social media. My family has a closed Facebook page where we discuss things. I would not want that to ever be shut down by somebody.
Yeah, exactly. And keeping on that, you know, the implications for our Pacific communities, you know, for the everyday social media user, we're quite vocal on social media. We like to share our opinions freely. What do you think the implications for us would be?
Well, the implications will be if this becomes something that's very tightly locked down, freedom of expression is at risk. But I am assuming the Prime Minister, the advisers are looking at this, but I'm hoping that they're looking at it in more than English, because different cultures talk about things differently, and that's what needs to happen. I marked a Samoan thesis about the use of Facebook by a Samoan family. That might not be something that other people think is okay because the discussion is so robust, completely appropriate to that family. Some might think when they're talking about their cousins it's hateful, it's not. But we need to, those things need to be considered.
Exactly. I mean, are we starting to see already a change in behaviour with people? Are we starting to see more self-censorship within our Pacific communities, do you think?
We are, and we're also seeing call it out happening. So somebody says something, somebody doesn't like it, the pushback or the blowtorch, the cultural blowtorch, happens so quickly now. And also as people become more adept with social media and are more educated, they're not going to take the kind of rubbish that happens. They will push back. And we see that also with people pushing back on the criticism of Israel. Folau, entitled to those beliefs, but people are defending him as well.
Well, thank you very much, Richard, for your comments this morning. Mei, takimata, for joining us.